The Murli's title is The Method for Churning and the Way to Increase Churning Power. Today, the jewel merchant father has come to meet his invaluable jewels to see how many jewels of knowledge every elevated soul has accumulated. That is, how many jewels of knowledge you have instilled in your practical lives. Each and every jewel of knowledge is more valuable than multi-millions. So, just think how many jewels of knowledge you have received from the beginning until now. The jewel merchant father has filled the apron of the intellect of every child with many jewels. He has given all the children jewels of knowledge equally and at the same time. However, the more you use these jewels of knowledge for yourself and for others, the more these jewels continue to increase. Bab Dada was saying that although the father has given equally to all the children, some children have increased their jewels, whereas others have not. Some are full, overflowing. Some have unlimited treasures. Some are using them appropriately according to the time. Some are using them for a task and are increasing them multi-million fold from one. Some are unable to use the jewels for a task as much as they should. This is why they are unable to understand the value of the jewels as much as they should. Your intellects have imbibed what you have received, but you are unable to experience the attainment of happiness, joy, power, peace, and a stage free from obstacles that you should have by using them. The reason for this is a lack of churning power, because to churn it means to put it into your life, to imbibe it. Not to churn means that just your intellect imbibes it. The former use this for every task and in every action in their life, whether it is for the self or the others. The latter simply remember this with their intellects, that is, they imbibe them. For instance, when you keep a physical treasure in your safe or locker and don't use it at the appropriate time or all the time, you don't experience happiness, but you just have the reassurance in your heart that you have that treasure. Neither will it increase nor will you have an experience. In the same way, if your intellect had just imbibed the jewels of knowledge, you just remember them and repeat them, saying that the point is very good, then for a short time you have good intoxication of that good point. However, you have to put the jewels of knowledge into your practical lives and into every action, because knowledge is not only jewels, but knowledge is enlightenment and knowledge is also power. So, if you don't use them with this method and practice, neither do they increase nor is there any experience. Knowledge is a study and it also an elevated battle weapon. This is the value of knowledge. To know their value means to use them for a task. And the more you use them for a task, the more you continue to experience power. For instance, when you don't use a weapon at the right time, then that weapon becomes useless. That is, it no longer has that much value. Knowledge is also a weapon, but if at the time for becoming a conqueror of Maya, you don't use the weapon, you reduce its value. because you didn't take its benefit. To take the benefit of something means to keep its value. You all have jewels of knowledge because you all have a right. But you are number wise in being full. You were told that the main reason is a lacking of churning power. Churning power is the basis of experiencing the father's treasures to be your own. When digested physical food becomes blood, because food is separate, when it is digested, it becomes your own in the form of blood. In the same way, with churning power, you experience the father's treasure to be your own. You experience them as a right and as your treasure. Previously too, Baddada has been saying that only when you grind your own ingredients will you feel that intoxication. That is, by using the father's treasures with your churning power, you experience attainment and your intoxication rises. At the time of listening to Baba, you have intoxication. But why is it not there all the time? The reason is that you have not made them your own with churning power. Churning power means to go to the bottom of the ocean, to be introverted and go into the depth of every jewel of knowledge. You mustn't just repeat them, but ask yourself first what the significance is of every point. Second and third, at what time and with what method must you use every point? Fourth one, with what method must you use every point for the service of others? So listen to every point and think about those four things. Along with churning, also go into the sweetness of its significance, become lost in the experience of intoxication. Use this when the different obstacles from Maya occur or when you have different problems of nature. Ask yourself according to the situation or according to the obstacle, whatever points you churn, will those jewels of knowledge make you or can they make you a conqueror of Maya? Did that happen practically? That is, did you become a conqueror of Maya, or is it that you thought that you would become a conqueror of Maya, but you had to labor instead of your time was wasted? This proves that the method was not accurate and that was why you didn't experience success. You also need the method and practice to use those things. Similarly, scientists create very powerful bombs. They believe that they will definitely be victorious with those. However, if the person using those bombs doesn't know how to use them, then even though they are powerful bombs, if they just fall here or there, they would be wasted. What was the reason? The method of using them was not accurate. In this way, every jewel of knowledge is extremely valuable. Situations and obstacles cannot continue when you have the jewels of knowledge and the power of knowledge. However, if you don't experience victory, then understand that you don't know the method to use them accurately. Secondly, by not constantly having the practice of churning, when you suddenly try to use them at a time of need, you are deceived. You have the carelessness that you have the knowledge in your intellect anyway, and that you will use it at the right time. However, you need to practice constantly and practice over a long period of time. Otherwise, what title will those who just think about those things receive? A Kumbhakarna, what carelessness did he have? He only thought, let them come and I will then be victorious. So the carelessness to think that it will happen when it is time deceives you. Therefore, continue to increase churning power every day. Whether it is the revised course, means Sakar Murlis, or the Avyakta Murli, you hear every day. In order to increase churning power, let your intellect imbibe one special point every day and practice with the method of the four things that Baba told you about. While moving along, while performing every action, whether it is for yourself or an action for service, let there be churning throughout the day. Whether you are in business or you go to the office or whether you serve at center. Whenever your intellect is a little free, repeatedly increase the practice of churning. Some work is such that while you are doing that work, you can also think about those things at the same time. It is for a very little time that you have to do work in which your intellect has to pay full attention. Otherwise, your intellect can continue to work on both things. If you fix such a time in your timetable, you can find a lot of time in between. It isn't that you have to find special time to use churning power. You can do it even while walking and moving around. If you have some time in solitude, that is very good. Go into the depths of the clarification of every point. Go into its expansion and you will enjoy yourself very much. But first of all, stabilize yourself in the intoxication of that point. Then you won't get bored. Otherwise, you just repeat the points and you then say, this is now done. What should I now do? When you spend the discuss of self-realization, some of you make Baba laugh. What should we think about? Our cycle finishes within 5 minutes. They don't know how to experience that stage, and so they simply repeat the knowledge. The golden, silver, copper and iron ages. So many births, this lifespan, this much time. That's it, and then it is over. However, to become a spinner of the discus of self-realization means to experience a knowledgeful and powerful stage. Now practice using every point to remain stable in the intoxication of that point and become one who knows of the significance of that point of knowledge. This was an aspect of the discus of self-realization that the father spoke about. In the same way, churn each and every point of knowledge and every now and then practice having an experience. It should not be that you just sit here for half an hour simply churning it. Whenever you have time, let your intellect have the practice of churning. When your intellect remains busy with churning power, you will automatically and easily became a conqueror of Maya. When Maya sees that you are busy, she automatically steps away. If Maya comes and you then have to battle to chase her away, and there is sometimes victory and sometimes defeat. That is the effort of the crawling stage. Now is the time to make intense effort. It is the time to fly. Therefore, keep your intellect busy with churning power. Through this churning power, stay absorbed in the power of remembrance. You will easily have that experience. Churning makes you a conqueror of Maya and frees you from all vast thoughts. Where there is no vast and there are no obstacles, you automatically have a powerful stage, the stage of remaining lost in love. Some of you think that you have very little of the said stage or the stage of powerful remembrance, or that you have an experience only after paying a lot of attention. You were told the reason for this last time too, that there is some leakage. The power of your intellect goes to waste. Sometimes you will have best thoughts and at other times you will have ordinary thoughts. To keep your intellect busy with the work that you are doing is known as having ordinary thoughts. At that time, you don't have the power of remembrance or the churning power that is needed, and you satisfy yourself by saying, "Today I didn't commit any sins. There hasn't been any wastage, and I didn't cause anyone sorrow." However, did you have powerful thoughts, a powerful state, and powerful remembrance? If you didn't have this, that is called ordinary thoughts. You performed actions, but karma and yoga were not together. You became one who performs actions, but not one who is a karma yogi. So, while performing actions, let there always be the experience of either churning power or the power of being lost in that stage. Both these powers are the basis of doing powerful service, because those who churn have that practice. They are able to create whatever stage they want whenever they want. By having a link, the leakage will end, and whatever experience you want, whether it is of the seed stage or the angelic stage, you will easily be able to experience whatever stage you want. When you have the knowledge in your awareness, then by remembering knowledge, you automatically remember the bestower of that knowledge. So, do you understand how you have to churn? You were told that Baba would tell you about churning at some point. So today, Baba has told you the way to churn, the basis of constantly being victorious over the obstacles of Maya and constantly experiencing success in service is churning power. Do you understand? To all the knowledgeable children of the ocean of knowledge, to the elevated souls who constantly became conquerors of Maya easily with the power of churning, to those who increase their practice of churning power and who experience the stage of being lost in love, to those who always know the value of the jewels of knowledge, to those who use the power of knowledge in every action, to the special, invaluable jewels who constantly remain stable in an elevated stage, Bab Dada's love, remembrance, and namaste. The spiritual children says namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Avyakta Bab Dada meeting groups. Do you experience yourselves to be souls who are intense effort makers? Time is moving ahead at a fast speed. As time is moving forward, with what speed should those who are going to reach their destination on time move? There is little time and a lot to be attained. So, if you want to attain a lot in a short time, you have to do it quickly. You are seeing the time and you also know the speed of your efforts. So, if time is moving fast and your speed is not fast, then time, that is the creation, is faster than you, the creator. Is it a good thing for the creation to be faster than the creator? The creator should be ahead of the creation. It is now the time to become constant, intense effort-making souls and move forward. If whilst moving forward, you stop to see sight scenes, then those who stop don't reach their destination on time. Any attraction of Maya is a sight scene. How would those who stop at sight scenes be able to reach their destination? Therefore, always be intense effort makers and continue to move forward. Don't think that you will reach your destination anyway, because there is still some time left. If you move at a low speed, thinking in this way, you will be deceived at that time. The sanskar of making intense effort over a long period of time will give you the experience of intense effort in the final moments. So always be intense effort makers. Do not sometimes be intense and sometimes weak. Do not become weak when something trivial happens. In that case, you would not be called an intense effort maker. An intense effort maker never stops but flies. So become flying birds and continue to experience the flying stage. Give cooperation to others and continue to make them into intense effort makers. The more you serve others, the more your zeal and enthusiasm will continue to increase. At the time of farewell, Dadi Janki taking leave from Bab Dada before going abroad. There is very good zeal and enthusiasm for service in this land and abroad. Where there is zeal and enthusiasm, there is success. Always pay attention that firstly, you always have zeal and enthusiasm and also the power of the gathering. When you have the power of love and the power of cooperation, you achieve success according to that. This is the field. When the field is good, the fruit it gives is according to that. However, if you temporarily make the field good and sow seed in that, you will receive fruit for a short time. You won't then receive fruit for all time. So, before receiving the fruit of success, always check the field. However, whatever each one of you does, you accumulate that anyway. You receive happiness now and you will have that in the future anyway. Acha blessing. May you be constantly victorious with the awareness of three expressions: to break, to mold and to forge, means connect. Explanation. The essence of the whole study and teachings are in three expressions. First, karmic bondages have to be broken. Second, your sanskars and nature have to be molded. Third, you have to forge all relationships with the One Father. These three expressions will make you completely victorious. For this, always have the awareness, whatever perishable things I see with these eyes have already perished. Even while seeing this, continue to see your new relationships and the new world, and you will never be defeated. Slogan: the sign of a yogi is that he or she is always clean and clear. Om Shanti.